Hey guys, what's up? It's Al. Welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I will be creating this makeup look that is fall inspired. If you guys can tell, it's very warm and kind of grungy-ish. So yeah, I created this look a few days ago and I actually forgot how I made it. So I've kind of just winged this tutorial, but I think that it turned out well naman. So yeah, if you guys want to see how I recreated this look, how I recreated my own look, then just keep on watching. Okay, so it's my third time filming this video, so hopefully this video turns out well because I want to upload a video for you guys because I've been missing out in action for such a long time. I know I have yet to explain that in a separate video or in another video, but right now I want to focus on the tutorial part. So yeah, I already applied my Milani Conceal and Perfect Foundation in the shade number 5, Warm Beige. I will be listing all of the products in the description box as always. And I also primed my eyes now with the Too Faced Shadow Insurance. You know, I love this because that's the only thing I always use. And then I will just set the rest of my eyes with a translucent powder or whatever powder you have that's close to your skin tone. Para lang maset yung base. Since I'm doing a kind of dramatic glam-ish look, it's important so that later on when I blend in the shadows, it will be a lot easier. It's very important to set your eyes. Mas lalo na kapag gagawa kayo ng smoky eye of some sort because life will just be easier for you. Next, moving on, I will grab my favorite crease brush, which is this Clover brush. And I'm going to take my Too Faced Shadow Insurance Palette. My Too Faced Chocolate Bar Palette. And I'm gonna take this shade right here. And I'm gonna use that as my transition shade. Since this is a fall look, I want a warmer transition shade. So I'm gonna apply that just on the crease area. Okay, now that I have my crease on, I will take this eyeshadow from Makeup Geek. It's in the shade Cocoa Bear. And I am going to slightly tap that on the brush. And I'll be tapping off the excess. And then I will be focusing this more on the socket and the crease talaga, as compared to the transition shade na mas blown out lang ng butterfly ko. This one, I want to focus it on the crease area. And then after I drag the eyeshadow in windshield wiper motions, I will slightly wing it out or drag it out to form kind of a cat eye. And I'll just do the same thing, grabbing Cocoa Bear, focusing it on the crease area, using windshield wiper motions. And then after I have that eyeshadow settled in the crease, I'll be dragging it into a wing. There. And then now that I have that on, I will be taking this ColourPop Super Shock Shadow in Lala, and I'll be taking my pinky and I'll just apply that all over my eyelids. This is such a perfect fall shade. I find that with ColourPop eyeshadows, it's better to apply it with your fingers. The color payoff is just better, or with a synthetic brush. So I'll just use my pinky, and that will be my eyelid shade. Once I have that all over my eyes, I'll be taking this eyeshadow from Makeup Geek again in Cherry Cola, and I will lightly dab my smaller crease brush on the eyeshadow, and I'll be focusing this color on the outer V. So I will press the eyeshadow on the outer edge, and then I'll be drawing like a V on the outer V, and then I'll drag it outwards like so. I'm not dragging it too much inside. I'm just focusing the color just on the outer portion. The same thing, pressing the eyeshadow just to the outer corner, then dragging it a bit in. You don't have to be super precise with the shape or how winged it is, because I didn't apply my concealer pa para I can easily clean up later and para mas ma-shape sa yung eyes ko. So I'm just adding a bit more of the eyeshadow because I want to intensify the eye look more. And then taking the same crease brush, this is smaller compared to the one I used a while ago, I'm going to take Coco Bear, and then I'm going to pinch this crease brush, and I'm going to apply it to my lower lash line. Next, I'm going to take this dupe lash glue that I got from Japan. I super, super love this lash glue. And I'm going to take this MAC Glitter in Reflex Bronze. It's a super nice amber bronzy shade, super perfect for the fall, and I'm going to apply that to the inner corners of my eyes for an added up to the look. So what I'm gonna do first is I'm gonna take the eyelash glue, apply to the inner corners, but I'm not gonna directly apply the glitter yet because I'm going to diffuse it blend it out a bit. R&D super concentrated yung pagkalagay ng glitter. I'm just gonna take a small brush, like an eye pencil brush, and then I'm just gonna take whatever's on the cap of the glitter and then apply it. There. Do you see that subtle effect? I want it to be a bit diffused. And you just wanna do the same to the other eye. Apply your glitter little by little. Don't add too much because it's easier to add a bit more at a time rather than to erase it because it's glitter. So, so I'm just going to take a dual fiber brush and then I'm just going to swipe off the excess glitter. And then I'm just going to conceal my under eye. For today, I'll be using the LA Pro Conceal as always and my Makeup Forever HD Concealer. I'm focusing the LA Girl Concealer sa dark areas ng eye bags ko. So, dito sa inner corners and sa outer corner. And then, I'm gonna take the Makeup Forever HD Concealer and I'm going to apply it to highlight. And I'm gonna take a beauty blender, not getting too close to the lower lash line because I already applied eyeshadow there, which I can just reapply, but if you can try to stay away from it and not getting too close to the glitter as well because sayang hard work. Blend out your concealer carefully. It's better to apply your concealer afterwards so that you can clean up easily. And yung glue kasi baka, I mean yung glitter kasi dumikit siya sa concealer. So after blending out your concealer, you wanna take a loose powder and just set the concealer and the rest of your face as well. Especially where I'm going to contour, and you just want to dust the excess powder off. To finish up the eyes, you just want to take cherry cola again on a smaller brush like this. And you want to get really close to the lash line. Then you want to stop halfway, so not going all the way in. Then just take another pencil brush or the same small blending brush you used a while ago. And then take Coco Bear and just blend. I'm going to take my NYC Sunny Bronzer and I'm going to warm up the face. I'm not going to be applying blush today, so I'm going to bring this kind of mid-cheek area now. I'm blending it down. And then I'm going to contour using my Kat Von D Shade and Light palette, of course. I'm going to take this neutral, cool toned brown shade and I'm going to cut the cheeks. I first apply the color and then when I blend it, I switch the brush this way. So I'm gonna do that the same technique with this cheekbone. Whatever's left on the brush, I just apply it to the sides of my forehead and to my lower jaw area and to my double chin right here. I'm also gonna contour the ilong because the ilong needs a little bit of love in too. Just gonna add highlight. I'm gonna take my soft and gentle highlight. Then for the lips, I am going to use Limbo on my lips. Because I would normally opt for a nude color, but for the sake of this video, I am going to use Limbo. And I still have lip balm on my lips because I don't want this lip to be super matte. Because it's going to... I don't really like ColourPop liquid lipsticks because it's super dry. So instead of it being a liquid matte lipstick, it's just gonna be a liquid lipstick. So I applied Limbo all over my lips, but since I didn't like the drying feeling of the ColourPop liquid lipsticks, I applied my Baby Lips Dr. Rescue Lip Balm. But since I don't like that glossy effect, I'm just gonna dab it with tissue. Kinda left that gradient effect, but I'm gonna fix that. Okay. So now that I applied my lip color and the rest of my face, I will finish the eye look by applying eyeliner. I'm just going to apply a thin line all over my eyelids and maybe a baby wing. I don't know. We'll see how it goes. So I'm gonna do the same thing to my other eye. And now I am back with my lashes. I just curled them and applied mascara and did all that, and yeah, that's basically the completed look here. How do you guys like it? Please let me know in the comment section down below. I really love reading your comments, and please help me out by commenting video ideas you'd want to see from me next. You guys want me to make a video about cheap brushes that I can recommend to you guys? I don't know, I'm running out of video ideas, so I need your help because in my next video, I will be having my giveaway. I already have some of the giveaway items with me. I just don't know how to give it away to you guys. So yeah, definitely watch out for that. I have yet to buy more giveaway items. It's just a small thank you guys, so don't expect such a huge giveaway. It's just really a small thank you. And I just wanted to give back for the 1,000 subscribers that I received couple of months ago. Kasi even if I stopped posting videos for some time, my subscribers still kind of grew. So thank you guys for that. And yeah, I don't know what else to say. That wraps up this video. Please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Don't stay posted for my future videos. I will talk to you guys soon and see you.